Back to the phones we go. Good morning, Bob Sokoler, Louisville Real Estate Show, News Radio 840 WHAS. Hello.
Hi, Bob. This is Paige. Yeah. Every time I find a home and want to buy it, it sells before I get a chance to put in an offer. How can I win and get my dream home?
Okay. So there's a couple of things.
Poor Paige.
So let's talk about this, Greg, because we train with our agents all the time of a variety of things. In fact, this has happened in the past couple of weeks. We've had multiple offers on multiple homes that we have listed. And that is, it's so difficult because it's not so much the ones that get the offer. It's the ones who we have to say to them and their agents, well, you didn't get the offer.
I guarantee you right now there's people out there looking to buy and sell that are listening to us that have had this happen to them. Because if they're looking in the, we know, the $100,000 to $300,000 price point where inventory is very, very light, you're going to go up against the best of the best agents and offers that are out there. And if you don't have an agent who has the tools in the box to help you win a multiple bid situation, things like...
So let's talk about tools in the box. Escalation clause
with a cap.
Right.
There are...
And if you don't know what that is, folks, we're more than happy to explain. We're not going to take time now out of this to explain. We got too many calls waiting, but you can always call me at 376-5483. And I make this offer to agents. If you don't know, please don't hesitate to call me or call Lee, and we'll explain it to you. It's a very interesting, very important part that's now legal to be allowed here. Also, letter.
Well, letters, writing letters, different ways to look at concessions if you need them, different ways to attack the seller, not attack, but to offer the seller something as enticing as possible to look good up against another offer.
So, for example, let's say a $2,000 minimum. So, in other words, in the inspection, you might write in for your buyer or for a buyer that if the home inspections reveal problems under $2,000, the buyer won't make any requests for repairs.
Yep.
It gets a little technically because you got to determine, well, who's saying it's $2,000 or below or above. But that is a possibility.
Sure. And also, you could also ask, if there are other offers on the table and what are the terms and conditions of those offers so that your buyer kind of has knowledge of what's out there already so that they could perhaps make a better offer.
So, Greg, say to me, you're the buyer's agent, I'm the seller's agent, and say, are there other offers?
Are there any other offers on the table, Bob?
Yes.
Okay. How many?
There's three.
Okay. Well, I'll do a couple things.
No, what Lee's saying is, but now ask me, Lee, ask me the question.
What are the terms and conditions of those other offers?
Are you kidding me?
Well, I know.
We're going to give up position.
That's why I wouldn't ask that, because I know you're not giving me that information.
No, that's right. Make your best and final by tomorrow night, 6 p.m., and we'll be happy to tell you whether or not you. So, listen, that's exactly right, but that's the way
and
it works.
Battling appraisal is another one. That's another thing that we know about. We've got some keys in looking at appraisals. If you're going to offer above, when we talk about the escalation clause with the cap, there are ways to look into preventing an appraisal issue. And if you don't know what
this
that could
true.
Be,
this one you
give
need
us
to
a
call.
Because
we won't give that one out. 376-5483. You missed one of our past shows on 840 WHS? No problem. Head to LouisvilleRealEstateRadio.com. Or go to Apple's iTunes podcast tab and search for Louisville Real Estate Radio, and you'll find us there.